For multi-core fibers, especially multi-mode, but also sometimes single mode, we use these MPO connectors. Or are they called MTP? If you want to find out, stick around and we'll check it out. Well, the short answer is both is correct, but there are some differences. So let's first have a look at MPO. MPO is an acronym and it stands for Multi-Fiber Push-On. It was developed in Japan by NTT in the 1970s. Later on, it was actually specified by the IEC and TIA organization for multiple companies to be able to manufacture the MPO connector and to make sure that they not were only compatible to each other, but that they also met certain specifications. The MPO connector is an array connector, meaning that it has one or more rows of fiber, and it uses the so-called mechanical transfer, or short MT, ferrule technology. Now, there are male and female connectors, and they're actually quite easily to distinguish because the male connector has these guide pins, whereas the female connector doesn't. On the contrary, they have guide holes instead. So let's talk about MTP. As I mentioned beforehand, MPO was an open standard, so we had multiple companies manufacturing the MPO connector, but some of these companies, they actually invested development resources in order to improve upon the mechanical and optical characteristics of the MPO connector. And so was the case for a company called US Connect. And US Connect, they developed their improved MPO connector and called it Multi-Fiber Terminated Push-On, so in other words, MTP. Now, unlike MPO, MTP is a registered trademark by US Connect, and since a lot of the improvements are protected by patents, only authorized and licensed companies, so for example HUBER+SUHNER, are actually allowed to manufacture the MTP connector. So what are these improvements of the MTP connector over the MPO? Let's have a look over here. Now, one of the differences is the shape of the guide pin, because as you can see over here, the shape of the MPO guide pin is chamfered here at the top. And that means that when mating it, it actually causes quite a lot of abrasion on the female connector. Now, the MTP, on the other hand, has this nice, smooth, elliptical shape of the guide pin, and that obviously causes much less abrasion. Now, these pins are actually spring-loaded, and that brings us to the next difference, because the MPO connector has the clamp for the pins made out of plastic, and the result was that the pins could break off or snap off. The MTP, on the other hand, uses a metal clamp. Now, as I said, they're spring-loaded, so in other words, as you can see here, we've got a spring, and that brings us to the next difference, because the MPO connector actually uses a round spring. And as you can see here, that spring is incredibly close to the ribbon fiber. And if the spring then does what it's supposed to do, it then actually can rub up against the ribbon fiber and damage it. And that's why the MTP connector then uses an oval shape, so and that then maximizes the distance of the spring to the ribbon fiber. Now, the biggest and probably most significant difference of the MTP connector compared to the MPO connector is concerning the mechanical transfer ferrule, because the mechanical transfer ferrule of the MPO connector is fixed. Whereas the MTP connector has this floating mechanical transfer ferrule. And that has a very positive effect on the mechanical characteristics of the MTP connector because it can withstand a much greater load before it actually loses physical contact. But in addition to that, it also reduced the insertion loss. So now the big question is, does that mean that MPO and MTP are not compatible? Well, no, because MTP actually is still based and still compatible to the MPO specification. But to be honest, it doesn't really make sense to combine those two connectors because you are losing all the advantages of the MTP connector over the MPO. So, I hope you learned something today and that you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a comment and remember to follow our channel to get your regular dose of brain snacks. Until next time, bye-bye.